Dr. Dastidar, tell us, you are also, in a sense, from the broad Congress family. Your leader 20 years ago was a Congress leader. Is there now a sense that the BJP is the rising force of the East? Who is your enemy number one? Is it the Congress or is it the BJP? You heard Adhir Chaudhary today attacking Mamata Banerjee, the Congress chief of Bengal. I want to know from you in a direct way, who is your enemy number one in 2019? Congress or the BJP?
Too many questions.
One question.
No, one by one. One is that Mamata Banerjee was suspended from the Congress party for protesting against the hand-in-glove attitude of the then Congress people with the CPIM, the ruling party here for 34 years, who had destroyed West Bengal. We did not leave the party. She had been suspended. That is one. Secondly, I was listening to you when the previous discussion was going on, so I would like to touch upon just two points.
No, I want you to first answer. No, I won't allow you to get. First answer this question, then we can.
People who said that we are running a rule of hooliganism. I just want to remind the gentleman, I don't know if he's here, we have pictures of him pillion riding with open AK-47 in his hand. He was sitting here just now. And the other one is that people who have killed, butchered, burnt, maimed, they pick up one picture and try to distract the course of action of this hall, this august audience, which is not right. We had to say this because at that time I lifted my hand, nobody allowed me to talk. Now, as you're talking about this East and West thing.
I want to know who's your enemy number one. Who's your enemy number one? 2019 election.
The regime which has unleashed a reign of terror and fear. It is not my word. These words of the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, who said, has included our country at 36. You know, when there are so many countries, it is at 36. That in India, there is at the moment an atmosphere of fear, apprehension, and they have included, I am ashamed that my country had to be included in that. And what is the fear? A fear that I'm not a Hindu. What is the fear? The fear that I'm wearing a skull cap. The fear that I'm a woman. What is this beti bachao, beti parao? In Delhi, you frequently go to the central hall. There is a joke going around that beti bachao is not save the girl child. It is, you know, be careful of your girl child. Hide her inside the room, lest a MLA or an MP of a particular party ruling the country now rapes, kills, or maims her. So they are our principal enemy, those people who have unleashed terror and fear in the mind of the Indians.
You're saying, therefore, that the BJP government of Narendra Modi is your principal enemy. They've unleashed a climate of terror and fear. Just a little while ago, Adhir Chaudhary of the Congress, sitting on the very chair you are of the Congress party, said, Trinamool Congress has unleashed a reign of fear and terror in Bengal.
I asked the question.
No, I'm unable to understand this.
We have pictures of him pillion riding with an open AK-47 in Murshidabad, capturing all the booths. So he cannot talk about this.
So who's your enemy? Adhir Chaudhary or Narendra Modi?
In West Bengal, they are such a marginalized force. They don't even have 3% votes. I'm sorry. So I cannot fight with a shadow. I have to fight with a proper enemy. So they are just 2%, 3%.
So your proper enemy is the BJP?
Our proper enemy are the people. Previously, in the 34 years, you have said just now that I have been with Honorable CM Mamata Banerjee for a decade or so, you said.
Yes.
I am with her for last 42 years. When I was in class 9, she was in first year because my uncle used to be the Congress president. He was the Pradesh Congress chief of West Bengal. So I'm with her for 42 years. She's a person who is pro-people. She does people's work. Her only agenda is to do development and good work for the common man of the... There is no unleashment of terror in this state.
Whatever they say,
I want them to prove it. I'm sitting here, let them prove it. They are killing women. You see, I can hear every time that I'm sitting alone, I can hear the whimpering of the child inside Kausan Baru's womb. They have used swords to slit open her womb to take out the baby. They have burned thousands of people. It's like a Holocaust.
No, one minute. Now, you know, you've now made it very clear the BJP is your enemy number one. Dr. Haleem, let's understand this. In 2019, who is your enemy number one of the CPIM? Is it Mamata Banerjee or is it Narendra Modi?
You see, Rajdeep, the Northeast is one place where the...
No, let's talk about Bengal.
I'm coming to that. The Northeast is one place where the entire idea of institutions are going to be deconstructed, and they are going to be deconstructed primarily with political parties. People are going to be part of political parties today, you don't know where they will be tomorrow. So I think so the institutions are being deconstructed. That's primary. One has to keep in mind, and that is what we are discussing today. In this context, it's the left that is going to sustain. Because the left is an organization that you will find very few examples of people leaving that party to join any other party. And the reason why I'm saying this is because the Bharatiya Janata Party is going to lead this. And one has to keep in mind, especially in Bengal, in 1998 when Mamata Banerjee left the Congress, the first person she went to was the Atal Bihari Vajpayee. And 6 years she was a minister in that government. 2002 she was a minister in that government during Gujarat riots. She sent flowers, she welcomed Narendra Modi's chief ministership. One has to keep that in mind. The second context one has to keep in mind very clearly is that what did Amit Shah say a couple of months ago? He said, we are going to focus on only half the seats in West Bengal. You know, Amit Shah is one person who enters a state and says, we are going to take over the entire state. He comes to Bengal and says, Mamata, I'm giving you a discount. I'm going to target only 50% of the seats. You know, that's exactly
what he said. I'm going to win 22 seats in Bengal.
Absolute.
I'm asking you very...
That's a clarion
signal. Who is your enemy number one?
I'm saying that's a clarion signal who to is his your rank and file
who
and
is
also the people on the other side that there are doors that are going to be left open. Because Rajdeep, you have to understand, the governance and the formation of government in India, especially in the Northeast, is not a pre-poll issue. It's not an issue of the mandate of the people. Anybody can win, but we are going to form the government. That's the attitude that is sweeping the entire country today. Irrespective, you may vote for a political party, anybody in this hall, but you're not confident whether that political party, that individual who goes representing that political party, actually ends up reflecting your vote. That's
Halim, the way we have reached here. Who is your enemy number one, Mamata Banerjee or Narendra Modi? Answer me straight.
We are very categorical. If you know our resolution, number one, to save India, we need to throw out Narendra Modi. To save Bengal, we need to throw out Mamata Banerjee.